sound, the chirping sound, as a continuous changing of frequency. Well, if we speak of frequency, the first thing we will come to is Fourier transform. Well, to do Fourier transform is simply expanding signals in terms of sinusoidal waves. So it simply expands the wave into different adding of sinusoidal waves. So it tells us whether it is added by different sine waves. So this is an example of its mathematical transform. If we have an f of x and we do sinusoidal transform to this, do Fourier transform to such a result, then we'll get such a function like this. So this is a short example.
Put two graphs together.
Yeah, okay. Well, here if we have, I believe that the wave package we're mentioning is like adding different hertz of sound together.
Yes, but that's the decreasing and the increasing amplitude of the wave package is because the lower frequency is canceling out the amplitude of the
So, yeah.
Like in your experiment, there's now a lower frequency to cancel out the pulse. So what do you think is the same effect?
Well, we believe that the reason that you said the amplitude is canceling out or adding up is because...
Look at the problem statement. It says I use a microscope, observe the branding motion of a particle of the order of a micrometer in size, investigate how the coefficient of diffusion depends on the size and shape of the particle. So now let's take a look at our observation. In our observation, we use the milk as our diffusion particles. And as you can see in this observation, that these milk fat particles seem to walk around randomly. That is seemingly chaotic motion. But however, that we are curious about one thing. Is it that seemingly this not ordered random walk have some
think about maybe, okay, with size go to infinity, the theory may go wrong.